Okay, I will start by drawing attention to something you are familiar with, and that is what we have something called decimal place. Decimal place, which is your DB. We have significant figures. Significant figures. So, and we have standard form. Standard form. Of course, maybe we have approximation. Now, the reason I want to start by just drawing attention to these four basic elements is because there are times where we give you a question and we ask you to give your answer in maybe two decimal place, three decimal place, or significant figure, or in standard form, or just to approximate to the nearest whole number. So if you don't know what those terms really stand for, you are going to find it difficult to answer such subjects. Now let's start with decimal place. Now if you have a fraction, okay, this is two is a number. Now if I divide two by any other number that is not divisible, let me say divide two by three. Now if I divide two by three, this gives me what we call a fraction. Now if I want to represent this fraction in form of a linear digit, I'll be having something like 0. Do you understand? 1 and so on. So this is something point. Maybe I'm having something like 3.1467. Now this dot is called the decimal point. Decimal point. So what? So if they don't ask you to express your answer in a particular decimal place, they are telling you that they want to see only some set of number after decimal point. For example, if I give you this figure 23.1467, now they ask you to express your answer in two decimal place. What they are simply saying is that we only want to see two number after this dot. That's the meaning of the two decimal place. If they say three decimal place, that means we want to see three numbers after this decimal point. If they say four decimal, we want to see four numbers after this decimal point. Do you understand? If it didn't just go on and on, and they say, okay, no, this your answer is too long ago. I just want you to express this answer in three, four, or five decimal places. So now this is what you do. Let's take for example. Now if you have a number between, I want to express this in two or three decimal places. Now what it means is that after we have count 1, 2, 3, we are going to approximate the remaining. So just to have the three figure that remains after the decimal point. So if you want to convert to decimal place, now what you need to note is this. If the number at the end of where the decimal point stop is between 0 to 4, you are going to approximate the remaining figure to 0. But if the number that remains after the last digit you want to stop is between 5 to 9, we are going to approximate it to 1. Now this is what I mean. If we have to convert this particular digit, this particular number we have in this digit into, let me say, two decimal place. Now we have 23.2 decimal place, means two number after decimal point. So the first number is 1, the second one is 4. So they say we should convert to 2, that means they don't want to see the remaining figures. So we need to approximate them. Now look at this number. The number after 4, is it between 0 to 4 or is it between 5 to 9? What's the answer? It's between 5 to 9, meaning that we're going to approximate it to 1. Do you understand? So all this number will turn to 1. So we now add that 1 to the last digit. So that 1 plus 4 will give us 5. So this is our answer to 2 decimal place. So this is the answer to 2 decimal place. But if you have to convert to 1 decimal place, and now look at, we have 23.1467. Now this is 1 decimal place, 1. This is one. Now, what is the next figure after that one? It's between 0 to 4. Is that not so? So because it's between 0 to 4, we are going to approximate it to 0. So 0 plus 1 is still 0. So that our answer will be 23.1. That is to one decimal place. I believe you're going to understand. It's very simple. What they're saying is that once you are to approximate to a particular decimal place, if it's to four decimal place, you can't four number after decimal points. So for to four decimal place, that would be 1, 2, 3, 4. So we stop here. If it's to four decimal place, so we're going to approximate the remaining. Now you want to approximate. What you approximate is the next digit after it. The next digit after it is what you are is what you are supposed to approximate. Do you understand? The next digit. Let's assume this digit here is, this is 3 and this is 7. Now you are to convert this figure to 4 decimal place. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4 decimal place. So your answer is supposed to be 23.1467. Why? Because the next digit after it is less than 5. It's just 0. So it's assumed that this is 0. But having been this number is 6, it was 6 initially. Now, even though the number, now look at this, this is 3. Even though the number after the 3 is greater than, it's between 5 and 9, which is approximated, but it's of no effect. What we look at is the next digit after the last digit we are considering. So, but if this is 6, for example, and we have counted our 4 decimal place, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 6 is greater than 5, it's greater than 4. So we are going to approximate it to 1. So our answer will now be 23.1468. So we had that 1 to the last digit. That makes it 8. I believe it's clear. So you can play back the video over and over again if you think you didn't get the explanation. I believe that it's very straightforward. Alright, so the next thing I want to talk about is significant figure.